On your cue, Mary. Good morning, ladies, and welcome to WOW. As you've noticed from the title of my WOW faith share this morning, mercy plus compassion plus patience equals peacemaking. And maybe on this morning in particular, this is relevant as we all woke up to the news of Ukraine now being invaded by Russia. So we're going to have our opening prayer is actually a song, a hymn. And Sue's going to sing the first verse through for us so that we get the pronunciation correctly. And it's in your black books, number 2127.
Kyrie.
Join me on the English words. Ready? Come and see.
Come and see.
How part two goes.
Christe, Christe, adoramus te, alleluia, Kyrie eleison.
Try that part with me. How do you want to do this?
Very nice, thank you. Beautiful, beautiful. So I wanted to explain to why this Kyrie eleison is on my mind. Those of you who were here last week know that Sue had the word, and everything was about the word, and that's how God spoke to her and the wonderful message that she shared last week. So this Kyrie eleison has been going on over and over in my mind since I was able to spend Christmas with my son, and I went to an Orthodox church to worship with him. Since he left and went away to college, he did his own exploration of which denomination and how he wanted to follow God. And some of you have heard this story already, but in all of his study, and his self-assessment, he decided that he was going to follow God through the Orthodox Church. And so when I was with him over Christmas for two Sundays consecutively, I was able to go worship with him in an Orthodox church, which I had never done before in my life. I've been to some pretty traditional conservative Catholic services, but this was decidedly different, quite a bit different than even the Catholic services. But they do a lot of this Kyrie eleison as a like an affirmation, and sometimes as a before they go into a formal prayer. So it had been going over and over in my mind, and then I had heard you might remember Mr., the rock group that sang Kyrie eleison. I'm like, what is this all about? Well, it means Lord have mercy. So that was the word that came to me, mercy. And the merciful. So let's have Carol read. Sorry, Carol.
hang on. He has told you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require you, but to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with our God.
Nancy's going to read from 2 Timothy 3:16 to 17.
All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that everyone who belongs to God may be proficient, equipped for every good work.
So in this time of unrest, and especially this morning with everything that we've heard, I think the scripture lessons that we can take and apply to even our own lives, our little corner of the world, to advance God's peace is so important. And I just wanted to review what it means to be merciful. So the dictionary says that it's kindness and gentleness, especially given to someone who's undeserving. And I know, you know, that's a great message for all of us. I don't know how many of you read Maria Shriver's Sunday newsletter. Nell shares it with folks, and that's how I got turned on to it. Thanks, Nell. But this past Sunday, she was featuring an author by the name of Mary Latham, and she has just written a book called More Good. This is an interesting story, a young woman who in our present day, our doomsday, you know, everybody is very negative about climate change and our political situation and global unrest, and, you know, we can go on. And I have to say that I am definitely one of these people. When I first moved back to the States after living in Canada for years, especially with all the politics that was going on, I felt like, oh my gosh, where have I landed? And I feel like, well, definitely that God has been revealing himself to me in really positive ways, and I feel like with each passing day even, I feel like I'm becoming less negative. And some of that is because of this kind of thing. So this woman went out, she was a young woman, she decided she was gonna find out where is all this negativity and gloom and doom coming from. And for 3 years, she was on the road, and she literally slept on strangers' couches. You know, she put herself at risk often, but in the end, she found out that there was more good and more positivity right here in the United States than she ever dreamed there would be. And that was the book she wrote, More Good. But a couple of the lessons that I took from the little blurb that Maria Shriver shared was that she said there is a shortage of ears in America. And that's very sad. And also, but even more, that kindness is time. And I think you could flip that around and say time is kindness, right? So hopefully those kinds of lessons, you know, to give people our time and our ears, that's something we all need to be doing more and more of every single day. Sue, I think I have you reading the next scripture. This is James 3:17-18.
But the wickedness of every kind, whoops, that's the end of that one. But the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, and then of mercy and good fruits without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. And a harvest of righteousness is sown in peace for those who make.
Okay, so what is compassion as compared to mercy? Well, those of you who have been following along with Pastor Matt's sermons know that he said that compassion is not a trait that's demonstrated by people without a relationship with God often. That the difference between mercy and compassion is that you know God's love, and so when you give mercy, it's full of God's love. I thought that was amazing. That was an amazing revelation to me. And I think, too, I don't know how many of you are enjoying all of these. We have a new one coming, right, for Lent. I actually keep these. I make notes in them. And I make bookmarks in them. I go back and I review them. So I have a few here, and that's where some of these references have come from. So from the Lent devotion, just the one from last year, this one said, "Our Lord's incredible love for us can move us to be patient, kind, and forgiving with others, even with all of their flaws, faults, and failures, even when we have been pained or wounded by them." For sure, that's God's love. God's love in us helping to give away that love to others who might have pained us, wounded us, and likewise us to receive it from somebody else in the same way. And then, Sue, I'm going to have you read Philippians 4:4-9.
"Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you."
Okay, so I'd like us to sing a hymn that hopefully will be familiar to most of you. "Make Me a Channel of Your Peace," number 2171. Okay, and then another quote that I really enjoyed in reading through my devotionals again, this one from Mary B. Sullivan from the 2019 Lenten devotional. And I thought this one was particularly relevant because there's so much slander in our world, right? Especially among the politicians and influencers and how they really try to undercut each other. And anyway, "and yet there is peace in making a right and loving decision and knowing that God's kingdom comes to fruition through all of our brave, costly, and contagious holy yeses." So saying no and not repeating things and you know, choosing the high road, right? I thought this was really interesting, too. There was a poll that went out for Valentine's Day, and they were talking to very young children. And one of the things that showed up kind of in social media, and I didn't verify this, but the quote is relevant, and I think really apropos. This was a four-year-old. They asked him what he thought love was, and he said, "When someone loves you, the way they say your name is different. You just know that your name is safe in their mouth." I just thought that was amazing. That's a very, that's an amazingly sophisticated four-year-old. I didn't verify it, but just that quote is amazing. Okay, so now we'll take prayers. Anybody have prayer requests?
I have a joy. 16 years ago today, my final dream was answered with little Jacob Anthony Mortellaro.
Oh, happy birthday, Jacob. That's lovely. Judy's friend Carol has been battling cancer for quite a long time, and I know she's got it in her throat, right? She has trouble speaking and swallowing. Prayers for her. A beloved family member that had cancer that had to be put down. Puppy dog, yeah. Well, I'm sorry, I was gonna say that. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't get to that part, but you're right, I should have. Grieving just the same, right? Anybody else? Ear surgery for Anne next week, Monday.
And Anne, when Anne moved to East Castle, she moved into my mom's room.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Full circle. Jane? Annette, family issue. Duffy Reimer's continued breathing and lung health and depression. Yeah.
I have a friend whose mom has cancer, but they can't let their little son know. And so trying to manage all of that. It's a complicated situation, but I said we would pray for the mom and the daughter.
So will you all, did we get everything? Everybody? Everybody join me in prayer. Lord God, you hear so many needs, hurt, physical challenges, emotional challenges, relationship challenges. But your love covers it all, Lord. Your Holy Spirit is full of power to heal, to bring comfort, to bring peace. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so one more hymn in your red hymnals, number 454. Thank you. like us all to remain standing and just read this prayer corporately. Closing prayer, everybody got it? Dear Lord, help me to be brave enough to shine a light upon my own life, one that reveals my blind spots and sees with spiritual eyes and hears with spiritual ears, so that I may better serve others. For I know that in serving others, I serve you, and that ultimately my holy yeses will further peace here on earth. Amen. Thank you, everybody.